वन आफ्टर द अदर, या दीपिका?
यस सर, एस्टरडे आई रेड न्यूज पेपर अराउंड 1 आवर. एक्चुअली आई रोट सम वोकैब ऑल्सो फॉर वन एडिटोरियल इन फॉर वन आर्टिकल इन एडिटोरियल कॉलम. आई टेक 30 to 45 minutes टाइम टू अंडरस्टैंड प्रॉपरली. आई थिंक इट्स ए ह्यूज टाइम. टुडे I engaged with reasoning classes. Till now, I didn't read. After the class, I have to read newspaper. Opening the newspaper is like for me horrible thing. Reasoning and English were reasoning and aptitude was good, and I am interested in GS, so I am go with that flow. I always neglecting these subject. Even. That's it for today. I have that's
Did
it.
You learn any vocabulary, new words while you were reading the paper?
Yeah, sir. 1 minute. Reprehensible. It's like ఖండించబడిన తగినది, లైక్ ఆ మీనింగ్ వచ్చేది సార్. ఇన్ఫ్లేమబుల్, ఇంకొకటి
వాట్స్ ద టైటిల్ ఆఫ్ ది న్యూస్ ఐటమ్?
జుడిషియల్ రిమెంబర్ ఇన్ ఎరా ఆఫ్ ఓవర్ క్రిమినలైజేషన్ లో చదివాను సార్ ఆర్టికల్ వచ్చేసి. That was yesterday newspaper.
So you could reduce it if you take if you took around 30 minutes, you could reduce it by at least 5 minutes. So it must be beyond our reach. 30 minutes when an article took 30 minutes, how can we slice it down to just 5 minutes? Maybe you don't need all the information in that news item.
Yeah.
So all you have to do is based on the title, you have to do sometimes wild guessing also, because it's not new for you. All English words, and you can just give a bird's eye view. There is a concept called bird's eye view. Bird's eye view means you don't read all the stuff, just you go through various title, you know, catchy words and phrases, some technical words, and you will come across the possible meaning of that particular you know, news item. That's all. So that way you can, because we don't need all the information in the reading comprehension also. The questions are properly set. They would keep the candidate face the tough talk, you know, time, and it's all about fear, in fact, sometimes. If you have thorough reading knowledge and if you know the strategies, you may be able to apply them. So all we know, we are not going to write any descriptive part, and we are not going to any, we're not going to do any analytical write-up. All we have is we need to pick the best answer. So that can be picked possibly in a very judicious manner if we know the trick of reading the entire stuff. The hardest task is when we have the passage from you know, a foreign subject. I believe, for instance, you did materials. What was your BTech program? MME? Or chemical?
Chemicals.
Chemical engineering. If it was from biology or as, you know, or medicine, for instance, you might find it a bit unknown. So in that context, all you can do is you read the questions first. Read the questions first, and you will be arriving at conclusions in less than what you have assumed or expected. The time would be saved there. All we have to do is in reading comprehension, we need to try to save the time. Then you will be the winner. Let's take some views from Susmita and her experiences. Susmita, over to you. Would you please tell us your experiences and work that you have done so far?
Yesterday, I read newspaper, sir. In that newspaper, I noted some vocabulary. Was there, I shared with you, sir. those are tyrannically, meaning is nirankusa palana. The usage is exercising power in a crucial or arbitrary way. And the another word is invoke, meaning is call on. And another one is convicted, means doshiga nidharinchadam. And verdict, teerpu, depriving. Using something, the city was deprived of its water supplies. Means kolpotundi, depriving means. And consensus is general agreement. And vague means aspashtamaina.
Yeah, thank
many
you.
Many patients suffered.
I guess this stuff would be very much useful for your synonyms and antonyms area. That's going to be an added advantage for you since you have been doing this kind of study very closely at grassroots level. This is going to be certain that it will absolutely be a prop sort of help for you. So synonyms and antonyms can be probably done. I'll give the stuff on synonyms and antonyms from now onwards. You please keep reading them, and that material will be very much helpful. It's going to test the higher knowledge of the people in terms of vocabulary. So basically, then you may be able to finish three topics in a single go. So if you do this kind of study parallelly along with comprehension, I believe these 4 and 5 bullets, synonyms and antonyms, you will be able to manage with your syllabus well. Then if you have got any extra time, you may be able to plan that time for your reasoning, GK, or any kind of Air Force regarding materials that you may think that they would ask, and you can get ready for that. It is examination in the month of August, isn't it? So how many phases are there in this examination?
Written and SSB interviews.
I think I'm quite sure that you are going to do it, because it seems you are very much particular about this exam and giving much importance to it. Don't dilute your interest levels. So keep giving much importance to it. Let's ask Porna. Porna Chandra. What's your journey in this regard? Have you read the content I have shared with you, or did you read any newspaper? If it is difficult, please turn off video. Speak on call. Voice call. Audio is enough. Tell us, Purna. Don't waste time. Well, let's take a look at the content that we have already got in this comprehension. And this area we discussed, reading with a purpose. Do we have purpose? Yes, we have purpose. Firstly, all we have to do and remember is we are not going to write any descriptive part in this examination. There'll be multiple choice questions. You will be picking the best option. But the possibility is it's likely that they try to distract our attention, and they try to make us feel much suspicious about the answers. We don't get the answer straight away, and we don't get the confidence also. We might have to be wild in guessing. That comes with practice. So please, it is necessary, read something with purpose and fix time. If you can't achieve in deadline, maybe you have to stop the task, and again, you please take another passage. So reading with purpose and time-bound purpose is necessary. The most important thing to settle initially is simply why a particular message is being read. Is it for relaxation, for getting information, or for discussion at a later stage? Is it serious? These are the various important questions. Is it for relaxation, getting information, or discussion for later stage? So should we have to read it? No, we are not going to read it for later stage discussion. We can keep it aside. And we are not going to read it for relaxation. That means it is not a pastime activity, and not even getting information, but partially it is to get the information. Why? The questions need to be answered so that we need to get information. Is it serious reading or light reading? So is it serious reading or light reading? This is the another important strategy. Are you doing your readings, activity or task seriously, or just trying to try your luck? Different kinds of texts are read for different purposes. What matters most is the overall purpose of reading. An engineering student has to read and interpret textbooks, research papers, and articles in technical journals, teaching notes, notices, web materials, directories, encyclopedias, laboratory instruction sheets, safety manuals and regulations, technical reports, and reference materials. Although the basic purpose of reading is to extract the information from various sources, it may primarily be to get an introductory idea of a text. This is important. So you are reading a newspaper or directly do the reading passages of various previous papers. So firstly, you need to get introductory idea of a text. What is the introductory idea? It means, what is the subject topic? What is the topic that is being discussed in the particular passage or news item? It is to get to a broader or broad understanding of the subject matter. Again, it is more or less similar. So we need to understand which aspect is being discussed and integral areas. Understand scientific ideas, theories, and principles. And these things, I think foreign students, I believe students who have done BTech in civil engineering, if they have a reading passage from zoology, they don't have to become distressed, or they don't have to become disheartened, since it is an unknown subject area. All you have to do is, you're not going to do something, research on this. It's just a matter of 3.5 minutes, I believe, in which you have to get the proper answers for all the questions being asked. So just the scientific ideas. What are the scientific ideas? The tabulation, or else the data, the database which is available. Certain theories or propositions proposed in the research, the reading comprehension and principles. If you are able to manage in identifying all these things, maybe you are going to hit the target. And to get, obtain specific information, yeah, we are not going to read just leisurely. It is to identify the specific information. Why should we have to remember this point? Why did he say specific information? He said, because the questions are to be considered first. It's not the comprehension passage. Even if you keep reading tirelessly, endlessly, for about 5 times, you may not arrive at conclusions. All you have to do is, you need to read the questions first, not once, but 5 times at least, quickly. Then each question has some related evidence in the passage that helps you save your time. So specific information means the exact answer for the question here. Understand new changes and developments in a particular field. Broaden one's outlook and understanding. These two things can be ignored. Why? You don't want to, develop or enhance some subject knowledge in particular areas. This is just an exam, a kind of qualifying purpose. So all we have to do is, it is to give our effort in a very meaningful way. But we need to be judicious in getting clarifications, as well as giving conclusions to the answers, because the closest related answers are going to put us at a tenterhooks, and we may have to face certain challenges that we need to understand. This is something like this. And let's take a look at the next component. Discover, it is to discover the others' viewpoints. This is essential. Please keep this point in mind. Others' viewpoints. Based on others' viewpoint, you may be asked one or two questions. So please be quickly, ready and vigilant to quickly analyze and get something from others' viewpoint. If something is asked in terms of others and his essential ideology, or to seek evidence for one's own point of view. Of course, point of view or ideology, or else thematic concern or objective, all these things actually go together. And this is simply because one particular author may have one particular or more than one, such as multiple purposes, in order to write an article, or maybe a text, or maybe a particular the thesis, research thesis article, in order to make the readers aware of that particular area. But here we are not going to study that area. All we have to do is, we need to be detached. Firstly, when we attempt reading comprehension, we need to be detached. Yes, it's not going to be with me, but I'm going to tackle this reading comprehension in a scientific manner. The be it from medicine, be it from engineering, be it from agriculture, be it from sociology, be it from culture or arts, whatever it may be, all I have to do is my tools. My tools are very clear. I have got my own tools. In other words, strategies. I'm going to employ them as the finest devices in order to get my answer. That's all. I'm not going to get much worried about what is there in the entire text, because I'm not going to read it. This kind of detached mindset should be born by the candidate before attempting any question in reading comprehension. So whenever you read a paper, don't think that you can learn everything in the article, even in the news items also. Just to try to get the integral points and others' viewpoint or main concept, that's all. In this context, you will be able to save a lot of time when you read newspaper also. Table 12.1, efficient and inefficient reading. So this helps us understand where we are. Efficient reading, the language of the text is comprehensible. Inefficient reading, the language of the text is not comprehensible. What do you mean by comprehensible? Let's check it once. Write down this word, comprehensibility, comprehensible.
Comprehensible.
Comprehensible, able to be understood. Able to be understood means when someone writes, it needs to be understood, which is in other words, intelligibility. So intelligibility. So intelligible or not, that means is it understandable or not. So language of the text is comprehensible, efficient reading, which means the learner has already got active vocabulary. When you are taking an exam of, you know, an exam on a par with the UPSC models, you need to update yourself with much knowledge. You can't simply take it for granted. You just have to be more thorough with the words and vocabulary. And I believe you need to be a voracious reader. Voracious reader is someone who can tackle with any kind of text. She'll be able to manage with, you know, words and certain phrases, idioms, as well as some other proverbs. And the technical jargon could be really foreign. And I mean, you just may not have to deal with all technical words, but 60% of the language in all reading comprehension passages is going to be possible to be dealt with. So you need to be comprehensible means you must have to deal with that. That's the only indication that you are ready to take that examination. The content is accessible because of the reader's familiarity with the content. Yes, when you are able to understand a particular piece of information, you have got all active vocabulary in your brain. The content is unfamiliar and far removed from the reader's knowledge and experience. If a reader has not given much practice over the period of time, it is going to be tough. So you need to be familiar with words. Some people might ask, how many words should I have to read? Or get, or how many words should I have to have in my repertoire? Repertoire means think tank. How many words should I have to possess? I mean, active vocabulary. No, there is no specificity, friends. Even though you have read for months and years, sometimes you may not be able to comprehend. It's all about the art of understanding a particular literary piece or else a technical, article. So the reader has background information to help understand the text. So background information means something that you have already known regarding that area helps you get some knowledge on the content. And the reader doesn't have or use background information. So inefficient reading comes from laziness, actually. Without putting any efforts, you just do a 5 or 6 tailor-made reading comprehension passages online and you get ready to give your attempt. Maybe on the exam day, one question might seem to be very okay and appropriate, but even that question might go wrong and you will absolutely be someone who might have to regret afterwards. So competitive examinations are not going to be very easy. So every time you must have to be objective in your scrutiny of this kind of models. So friends, get as much as possible, all the knowledge that is required. The reader concentrates on the important parts of the text. This is very important. You are not going to read entire text. You will have to concentrate on the important parts of the text. Think ahead. Think ahead means think laterally. We know Edward Buono has proposed lateral thinking concept. This is again called, you know, our thinking out of box. When someone goes in linear fashion, you may have to go in a different way to just save your time and then understand the total gist of the passage and hypothesis as well as predictions. So hypothesis might also help you. This kind of technicality or else device usage comes with proper knowledge acquisition. You need to acquire. Acquire means to obtain or to get. So if you keep reading regularly for more than 30 minutes and 40 minutes as well as even if you read for an hour, that would still be okay. The reader pays the same amount of attention to all parts of text. He, she does not think ahead, but deals with the text as it comes. This is mediocre knowledge. People with less reading skills, I'm sure you can easily beat people in the present generation, Deepika, Purnachandra Rao and Susmita. Why I tell you this? I have observed quite a range of students. They have not become good readers. The reason is people are not able to invest time for reading textbooks these days. They are not able to find time. They're simply spending time with WhatsApp messages and multimedia, social media, all these videos. Even serious candidates who have a lot of passion in the beginning starts getting diluted. The days go by. Why it happens means it is one's own particular reason one has to give, but we can't say that. But one important drawback in the present generation that might be a very big scaffolding for the serious candidates is the distraction towards this particular technical development, social media. So if you are thoroughly serious, I think you are going to hit it. The reader has a clear specific purpose. Efficient reader has a clear specific purpose which motivates him or her to read. So a specific purpose. In the examination hall, you will be very alert. You will be very alert. You will be very concentrated and you'll have focus, attention, everything makes you stay alert. But a person who is not efficient, he doesn't have clarity and purpose and does not use the same strategy for all texts. So that means uses a kind of a strategy that is mundane, simply lifeless and illogical kind of thing, and common reading as if it is reading in the academic textbook in order to get an answer for the descriptive question. That experience is not going to be helpful at all. The reader is able to use different strategies for different kinds of reading. So this is called a multiple perspective. When your brain works differently in the given context, you are going to work efficiently. In other words, in English, there is a word called ambidexterity. When someone is ambidextrous, he can use right hand and left hand at the same time. So ambidextrous, you need to be ambidextrous. So you need to have this kind of quality. Today, people are striving and struggling a lot to get government jobs. That took, central level jobs. That's not going to be easy, friends. So words do not help, but actions help. So we need to be multiple perspective students and learners. The reader is not able to use different strategies for different kinds of reading. Obviously, we know one who has not paid much attention towards reading, one who has not invested time, energy levels, how can we expect that fellow to deal with very tough paragraphs? It's not possible. Finally, the reading is fast. And for the efficient reader, her reading is very slow. So slow and even rather slow. That's very simple. Yesterday, we had some inputs from Susmita. She was telling us while she was reading, she was not able to cope with the kind of the yardstick, the parameters which she had felt to be very essential in order to do the nice reading formally. That means she was taking time to understand sentence by sentence, which tells us that experience tells us that you students have to give much importance to reading regularly. That's it. Whether it is helpful to you the moment or not, but you must have to every day just keep one or two news items, articles with you, and you must keep reading them. Now let's take a look at progress checking here. Study the following statements about the process of reading and mark true or false against each of them. I think you have to do it. We have got around J. So can you read the first one, Deepika?
Reading is a complex communicative process of receiving and interpreting the written word.
Interpreting.
think it's true. Sir, you are in mute.
Yeah, thank you. Please keep your answers with you and say state whether it is true or false for each one of them. And afterwards, we can check later. It helps us understand whether we have really got the essence of this reading comprehension passage. So these are the few nutshell points which will pave the way for the better progress in reading comprehension. And the second one, Susmita, read the B.
Please. While receiving and interpreting the written word, the reader is not concerned with the comprehension.
While receiving and interpreting the written word, the reader is not concerned with. The reader is concerned with comprehension.
Comprehension.
Is it so? Think of it. If you are not concerned about comprehending means understanding, how are you going to get the answer?
False.
You have to understand this point. See, Purna Chandra, please read it.
Decoding or interpreting in reading refers to the process of changing the coded message into information.
Get the answer. You need to write the answer in your notebooks now. We shall have the answers later. D. Deepika. Read one after the other.
Text analysis refers to the progress of identifying the central theme, main ideas, supporting details, and writing patterns.
Next two.
The reader's response to a text depends on his or her subject knowledge.
The reader's response to a text depends on his or her subject knowledge. Is it so? Think of it.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Chandra.
Efficient reading does not involve the use of background information to help understand a text.
Deepika.
An efficient reader pays the same amount of attention to all parts of a text.
Susmita.
An inefficient reader is not able to use different strategies for different kinds of reading.
Next.
An efficient reader is aware of a clear specific purpose in reading and motivated to read.
And is there and is motivated to read.
The basic purpose of academic reading is to extract information from various sources.
Second one, which of the following may not result in efficient reading? Unfamiliar content? Clear language? Background information? Can you look at the question? It's not very direct, it's an indirect question. Which of the following may not result in efficient reading? It's not result in efficient reading, it's may not result in efficient reading. First of all, you have to understand the question. Look at the question first. Background information, clear purpose, lack of motivation, use of effective reading strategies. This is, it is very essential for effective reading, and clear purpose is necessary. Background information necessary, background. Clear language, unfamiliar content. Yes. Simply?
Lack of motivation.
That means though there is no lack motivation for him, for her, efficient readers can manage with their strategies. This is what you need to understand. This question itself is very important that you can understand here. So let's take a look at the progress check. Which of the following reading activities require a basic understanding of the subject from and familiarity with the material? Reading entertaining messages, reading general texts, reading reference materials, reading business documents, reading scientific and technical texts. Which one would be the right answer for you?
scientific and technical texts.
Which of the following reading activities require a basic understanding of the subject knowledge with the material? Usually scientific and technical texts, isn't it? Reference materials, business documents, general texts, entertaining messages, people are quite familiar with them. But scientific and technical from one field to the other field, people may have to switch to different genres. It is not possible. Anyone who has done a PhD, maybe in one field, somehow allied sectors could have some impact in her brain to understand. But all of a sudden, in technical text might come in, it is difficult to understand the overall composition of the text. So this is the appropriate answer. Active and passive reading. Reading is not merely a passive process of absorbing the message encoded in the printed word, but a dynamic communicative process in which the reader approaches the text for a particular reason. You need to be an active reader rather than a passive one. What do you mean by passive one? You will not have any enthusiasm. You will not have any strategy. You will simply attempt the reading comprehension passage with just basic knowledge that you have acquired so far. Active reading refers to a set of reading practices you may use to help understand the meaning of a written message. So active reading, passive reading differences are there. And now Deepika and Susmita. Deepika will read active reading areas and Susmita will cover passive reading points. Your time starts now. Go ahead.
Active reading. The reader pays attention to both content as well as style. I need to read all the... Sir, shall I continue or one by one?
Susmita, please read the point under passive reading.
Sir, I'm not able to see total.
What, Susmita?
There is a prop. Sir, total sentence matam kanipinchaledu.
Maybe you have not put your aspect ratio of the text, I mean the screen. Arrange it properly. From your end, it's there.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Passive reading, the reader pays attention to either content or style.
The reader interrupts and analysis what
interprets.
Okay. Sir, what is the meaning of interpret?
Interpretation means it's defining, analyzing. Okay. That's the idea.
Okay, sir.
Some critical analysis, in other words. We say usually interpretation of a particular literary text. So interpretation means giving a complete critique on that. So describing, in other words, in simple language.
Okay, sir. The reader interprets and analyzes what he or she interprets and analyzes what he or she reads.
Analyzes.
What he or she reads in order to understand both explicit as well as implicit meaning of written message.
Passive reading, the reader does not analyze what she or he reads.
The reader predicts and responds to context.
A passive reader, the reader does not predict and respond to context.
Prediction and response. Very, very important. Prediction means going for wild guessing. It could be this. It must be this. When he has used this, I think this could have this relationship here. That's the reason why this question has come. So this kind of prediction will automatically drive towards the betterment of one's chances to get the marks. But the passive readers usually, they don't know all these things. They don't predict, they don't respond.
The reader pays attention to the writer's intention.
Passive reader, the reader does not pay attention to the writer's intention.
Yes. What do you mean by this? There are two different versions, Deepika, Purna and Susmita. Listen to me.
Yes.
When we read something, we always judge a literary piece based on our previous knowledge, based on our vocabulary. For instance, people might say, It is always food to pronounce, but it is pronounced food. Unless you learn the accurate pronunciation, someone says at least, it is not possible to you to use ever. You might say food, 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 food. The pronunciation never changes. Similarly, one who has not given one who has not considered reading to be a very important area may not know something beyond what she has already got. So that's going to destroy the opportunity, that going to kill the opportunity, because always the subjective analysis rules in that particular mind. So subjectivism is not going to be helpful. Subjectivism means thinking and defending oneself with one's knowledge. And we need to give importance to objective mind, objective mindedness or objective analysis. Objective analysis means, this is, he has written like this, this is something. Would it have been different? Should I have to think differently? Why must it be like this? It can't be so simple like this. It could have been something different. When you start thinking like this, you may at least get some layers of thoughts which help you get the right answer. But if you think, this is exactly what I think, this is very easy for me. Something which is difficult, which takes at least 10 minutes, the dullers or passive readers and people without strategies might finish it in just 1 minute, thinking they know it. They pat themselves and they think they are quite smart. But after the results are out, they have to regret, because no question paper in competitive examinations, particularly in English, will never be easy. And day after day, it is becoming increasingly tough. This has to be born in every aspirant's mind. Next.
The reader differentiates between ideas, opinions, feelings, and facts.
Susmita.
The passive reader does not distinguish between the factual and non-factual information.
What do you mean by distinguish here, Susmita?
Distinguish means differentiate.
Fantastic. To identify the variations. Next.
The reader infers the meaning of unfamiliar words from contextual or internal clues.
This is very important again. The reader infers. What do you mean by inference? You have done many tasks in this particular area. Inferencing means guessing. Simply guessing. You guess the meaning of unfamiliar words. Be prepared. Be prepared when you take an exam. Do not be complacent. What do you mean by complacency? I know everything. I have done very well. I have worked hard daily 10 hours. So this is going to be easy. This kind of overconfidence is nothing but complacency. Please quit it. Today you keep that complacency hat and wear the composed hat. Always tell yourself that something I have learned, but there is a long way to go. If you have to say yourself, then things will somehow be practical one day, and they will yield better results. What do you mean by inferencing? Guessing. Sometimes you are not going to get the reading comprehension passage. One question may definitely be there to test your vocabulary. So if that word is difficult, please go to the context. Go to the context and some words supporting details around it in the previous paragraph or even after that may help you to just figure out which might be an appropriate answer for the question options given. That way you may be able to manage. Otherwise, you might have to feel very much upset in the exam. Your feeling sick becomes dominant and later predominant, and leads you towards a lot of dissatisfaction. When you feel dissatisfied in the examination, the next questions and further attempts in the same question paper and in different areas may have to be minimized. I think inferiority complex and lack of self-judgment and lack of self-esteem and lack of self-confidence and contraindication in this context, again, overconfidence and subjective feelings that whatever I know is correct kind of feeling, and subjective mindedness, such things will be the bottlenecks for any aspirant. So whenever you feel that you still have to learn something, and when you are open-minded, you are going to guess. So infer the unfamiliar words. That would become part of your question paper tomorrow. Very, very important. I have seen many people in a competitive examinations, they're taking examinations without all these ground realities. They simply attempt online daily two reading comprehension passages I'm doing, but when the last day at the 11th hour, when the last day arrives, when they come to know all these things, psychological manipulations and psychological preparations are the most important elements, friends, than one or two reading comprehension passages. The tailor-made answers you come across and feel confident, that's not going to be helpful. Conceptualization of particular theme is very, very important. So this point helps you, and be prepared. You may have to face and deal with unfamiliar texts and unfamiliar words as well as phrases. What about passive readers?
The passive reader does not infer the meaning of unfamiliar words from the contextual or internal clues.
It's as simple as that, friends. Passive readers are lazy people. So why is it here? Tomorrow, do not get worried about the number of participants for this examination. So if the number is 10,000 for AFCOT or any other exam under UPSC or APPSC or SSC, any other examination, let me see my luck batch is going to be 90%. So let me try and let me see my luck. Let me try my luck, or let me see my possibilities. Perhaps we can shun out or rescue such people from our minds. Then we can declutter our brains, and we can, you know, bring peace in our preparation, and we can maintain consistency, and we can strategically move ahead. And that helps us stay always motivated. Self-motivation helps. Remember, passive readers are lazy people. They only apply. They never work on their syllabus firstly, at least. They don't know what syllabus is. They might probably do 1 week program or 2 weeks. And you see, without smartphone today, people don't eat, don't drink, don't sleep. Smartphone has become everything. But you being a real, very, very solid, you know, COMET exam aspirants should have to use your smartphones judiciously, in the sense wisely. If you are not that lot, I'm sure your efforts might go in vain. I don't know, but I don't want to see that, because you are young and you have dynamic qualities. Manage well. So readers, why it is there on the right side? Tomorrow, you know, in your examinations, you know, hall, on your left side and on your right side, there are people from the right side category. So they would sit with you, giving you much a psychological, you know, impatience, and psychologically some kind of commotion, tussle. Never worry about that. Those people are not real competitors for you. You are the real competitor for yourself. Next point. Again, you know, I think opposite word, passive readers. Did you read, Susmita?
Yes, sir.
Next.
The reader identifies and evaluates a writer's attitude.
The passive reader does not identify or evaluate a writer's attitude.
That's it. Identification and evaluation. Writer's attitude. Again, it was discussed simply. You can mostly try to be from objective point of view. You need to be objective reader. Objective reader is someone who always tries to look at the external meanings and external aspects than simply surface level understanding. So that you need to understand. Next point.
The reader understands and interprets graphic information.
The passive reader does not interpret graphics.
So why can't he or why can't she do that? Because lack of previous knowledge. So who gets knowledge? One who has passion. So someone who is ready to deal with competitive aspirants, he or she would always learn various aspects of that particular examination. So qualitative and quantitative, two important themes are there when you read particular text. Qualitative means you will find a kind of story, and quantitative means you might find some, you know, some kind of, you know, some representation of Venn diagrams and bar charts and pie diagrams and some tabulations. And sometimes, see, you may have to know all these things, some basic mathematics, some mensuration and numerical ability. Feeling that I am from mathematics background is okay, but if that feeling dominates your overall preparation, you may have to pay the high price. So in the reading comprehension passages, get ready to analyze the graphics as well as certain information that is crucial under quantitative analysis models. And last one.
The reader draws inferences and conclusions.
No, not inferences only.
Inferences.
Yeah, drawing inferences and conclusions. Simply wild guessing. So you just guess it because you need to spare time for other questions. You can't stick around only one or two questions under reading comprehension. This is going to be only one of the main aspects, and other aspects are also there, other areas of your question paper. Those you must have to be very much proactive, and you need to be dynamic, and you have to be quick enough. Very swiftly, you have to take decisions. So I can tell you one thing, decision making helps in competitive examination stay ahead than others. Millions of thousands of tens, hundreds, thousands of people to apply for this, but they can't draw conclusions. They don't have capacity. All readers, I am sure, are just surface level readers, and people read just for the sake of passion. You know, reading for 10 minutes these days is difficult for people. They want to listen to, or sometimes they want to get entertainment jokes and all. So you can imagine that if you are serious, I'm sure 50% of your efforts would become very much fruitful. And how about passive one?
The passive reader is only concerned with the literal meaning of a written message.
Yes, the reader is only concerned with the literal meaning of a written message. Literal meaning, whatever is given, you know, on the paper. So parrot has come, I gave some seeds, it ate seeds, one seed was there, it did not eat, it hopped towards me and left letter, something like this. Literal meaning, whatever is literal in a literary sense is conveyed, that he can probably acquire. Does active reading is interactive and productive? It facilitates proper interaction, produces new understandings. It promotes more effective encoder-decoder relationships. During your free time, please also learn that the concepts of encoding and decoding and reading, comprehension, this somehow helps you and helps us take advantage of opportunities we might miss by being passive readers. So passive readers are lazy people. Passive readers are people who try to find their luck in the competitive examinations, but competitive examinations are not for them. So don't get worried, never get carried away by a certain, overwhelming imagination. Sometimes that might sap us down and we might become susceptible to such weak, incongruences. And we may sometimes become so nervous, and this nervous breakdown will reduce the chances of standing atop. So friends, this is it for today's session. And please do the progress check 1, 2, and 3 also. And I think we can probably do one or two reading comprehension passages maybe tomorrow. I think tomorrow will be the last class for this week. And I shall not conduct classes on Saturday and Sunday. Okay. So again, we shall meet on Monday, but tomorrow there will be a class. Probably I shall give you two tasks on reading comprehension. Be prepared for that. In the meanwhile, get your interest levels and juices of concentration, and mostly your appetite. I mean, appetite is used usually for eating food. I'd say appetite for learning. So please multiply and enhance, and let the sky be limit for it, and never just look back and never try to become disheartened. Rome was not built in a day. You are doing a fantastic job. I wish you good luck. We shall meet tomorrow to take two reading comprehension tests. They are just going to be improvement kind, and you are going to get some knowledge. Have a great day. Thank you. Good night. Would like to ask any questions?
No, sir.
All right. Please. Good night. Take care.
Thank you, sir.